theCUBE at Hadoop Summit 2014 is brought to you by anchor sponsor Hortonworks. We do Hadoop. And headline sponsor WAN Disco. We make Hadoop invincible.
We're here live at Hadoop Summit. It's theCUBE, our flagship program. We go out to the events, extract the signal from the noise. I'm John Furrier, the founder of SiliconANGLE. We're with Sid Sipes, director of Big Data for SAP. You can probably see their booth in the background. Welcome to theCUBE.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
So while you're here doing big data missionary work in this great community, SAP's having Sapphire now in Orlando, which we've been to every 4 years except for this year. But different show. Sapphire's huge, it's like Oracle Open World, it's a monster.
Sapphire is huge, and actually I'm actually rather pleased to be here. This is much more relaxed, much more informal, and just a different kind of vibe.
And you flew in last night from Miami. You manage the partners. Tell us the perspective that you have, because SAP certainly has the Ferrari of big data in HANA.
Right.
They have a cloud, some say it's getting there. Some say, including myself, you can refute that, but certainly big company.
I understand.
Got big success. So you guys are a huge software company. You have all the big clients.
Right.
So it's not new conversation for SAP to talk about big data. It's just a question of how.
Right.
So tell us how you look at the how do I roll out big data in context of the Hadoop's emerging ecosystem.
Well, maybe I should back up a little bit and kind of give you an overview of our strategy. And it really revolves around an end-to-end solution. And anytime you talk an end-to-end solution, you have to talk all the way from ingestion all the way through processing and storage. And that invariably includes a Hadoop discussion. Every customer we talk to is either investigating Hadoop, they're talking about Hadoop, or they've been told they have to use it. So at SAP, if we want to have an end-to-end type of solution, we have to have a solution that includes Hadoop and many other partners in the ecosystem, not just Hadoop.
So the ecosystem seems to be vibrant right now. You see success.
Right.
It seems that there's so much market opportunity that there's not a lot of conflict, so although there might be different approaches, Cloudera, Hortonworks, MapR, SAP, I mean, you got SAP, IBM, Cisco,
right.
AT&T, those are the whales. They guys are the top tier companies. The pre-IPOs are here, and then the startups.
Right, so you're right, we are one of the bigger ones, but we see a lot of movement, a lot of excitement around the smaller ones, the startups. We see a lot of excitement around the Hortonworks and the Clouderas. And we see a lot of opportunity in partnering with them. In fact, if you go out and look at our customer base, a lot of them have already made a decision to go with one or the other, which says to us that as part of what we build, what we offer, we have to basically integrate and play with all of them.
So you guys are a great distribution for startups. So if I'm a startup, and I, by the way, I live in Palo Alto, so great track record of the innovation lab there with mm-hmm. startups. You guys do a lot of work, and you have an incubator and venture firm and whatnot. So, it's clear you guys work with startups at that level, but as startups start to grow, SAP could be like a distribution outlet for them. How do you guys work with, you partner with these guys.
Right.
What's your value proposition? What do you say to them? What's your pitch?
Well, one of the pitches and what they're most looking for immediately is, hey, you guys are big, you have a lot of customers already, you have a huge customer base. How do we get a hold of that, or how do we become part of that? And that's really kind of an entry point for a lot of partners. But what we really want to see is we don't want a partner that says, hey, I just want to access your customer base. We want a partner that says, hey, I can bring something to the table also. And together, the two of us can go forward to either customers or joint customers and offer something greater than just living off one or the other's customer bases. So that's how we view partners, and that's what we're looking for in partners, to be honest. Something that we can do something greater together.
So you work at the big company. At SAP,
yep.
You're at the small people here in the Hadoop ecosystem. When I say small, I mean small companies.
Right.
You know, nimble, fast. Interesting culture clash, because SAP is still an innovative company and very German. I always love to say, like, it's a sports car. I mean, it's a very innovative culture. McDermott is a great CEO, big fan of him. I like Schnabe too, but he stepped aside. When you come into the ecosystem here, it's a little bit different. It's a lot of developers. So,
right.
What's your take on that, and how are you guys dealing with these guys? Is there how are the business relationships? What's the technology you're sharing?
Actually, we're doing everything we can, and actually to survive, we have to be innovative. We can't just live on our past successes, and we can't live on our customer base. So SAP has to innovate, and that's partially where HANA came from. But also we understand that with our partners, and in order to get our partners into the ecosystem, or our prospective partners in, and to get partners excited and using our technology, We do everything we can, including outreaches to them, including partner developer days, where we actually bring partners or actually customers in to where they can get their hands on the technology, start learning it, get excited about it, and then maybe come up with new and exciting joint offerings that can come out of that.
What's the most exciting thing that you've got going on with SAP and some of the relationships here?
I think the future is almost unlimited. What we see happening with big data, the combination of the traditional SAP type of business data with all of the new data that's coming in, the non-traditional data, data from sensors, from factory floor, from cars, combining that with the traditional data, whether it's in strictly an SAP system or a combination of SAP and Hadoop, that's what's exciting. That opens up huge possibilities, huge potential for our customers, and of course that translates into potential for us.
You know, it's almost interesting. SAP's always been anti-Oracle in the old classic software company, you know, orientations. You've always been more open, more multi-vendor.
Right.
We saw the announcement you guys had with EMC, Joe Tucci and Bill McDermott at EMC World. And it kind of fits nicely with the heritage of SAP with Hadoop Summit because it's a Lego block composite application mindset here, right?
Right.
It's DevOps, right? It's like DevOps is like, dude, don't force any crap on me if I don't want it. If it's crap, I don't want it. If it's good, I'll take it. I'll only take the good stuff.
Right.
That is a composite Lego block design. So you guys play well in that environment. Is there some things within your portfolio that match better for Hadoop in a Lego block mindset than others?
I think we have quite a few things that match well with Hadoop. First of all, there's HANA. Any conversation with SAP has to start with HANA. But when you look outside that, you look at some of the other products that we have, some of the analytic tools, some of the applications. A lot of our customers are asking for applications, something that I can show immediate value rather than me having developed something from scratch. Those pair very well with not only HANA, but HANA and Hadoop, or maybe just Hadoop. So we're seeing a lot there.
Yeah, I saw one of you guys gives people stick out sentiment analysis tools built in, like, oh, right. Yeah, just take it, why build it?
Right, a lot of our customers are basically risking a lot when they make a big decision or a big purchase, and they want to be able to show their management or their board some immediate value. So by offering these kind of applications, it may not be 100% fit, it may not even be close, but it allows them to go to their management or their board and say, hey, look, the investment the risk that we took and the investment we just made with SAP is paying off very quickly. I can show you immediate value. And we see a lot of requests for that kind of interaction.
Sid, thanks for coming on theCUBE. Really appreciate you taking the time. I'll give you the final word. Share with the folks out there, why is SAP here and why do you look at this ecosystem as very important?
So SAP here is here basically to interact with our ecosystem and basically to help describe our big data strategy and help our customers and partners understand where we fit, how they can fit, and how together we can be bigger out there in the real world.
Okay, this is theCUBE. We're here with SAP, one of the big whales, innovating in big data, certainly at a large scale. Sapphire's going on in Orlando, along with IBM, AT&T. This market is real, it's happening, it's about serious business and business outcomes. That's going to be the conversation for the next decade. Technology is evolving fast, you guys are involved. Thanks for coming on theCUBE. This is theCUBE, right back with our next guest after this short break.